Hello, friends, and welcome back to GFC Visions, Growing in Friendship with Christ. I just watched a short video put together by a priest whom I've met on one or two occasions. I don't know him well, and he's probably doesn't know who I am. I'm sure he wouldn't remember me. But his name is Father Frank Pavone, and he's the head and priest director of the group called Priests for Life, a religious order that was founded maybe 25 years ago in the United States as a way to proclaim the gospel of life and to assemble a really strong group of priests and religious to proclaim the gospel of life in a very very coherent and a very clear way, not only to the people of the U.S., United States, but to the whole world, because the issue is critical. The future of the human race depends upon the protection of the right of every human being, which is a God-given right that is not given by any state, and it's not given by any political party. It's given by Almighty God Himself. God has endowed each and every human being that He creates from the first moment of conception with the sacred dignity of being created in His image and in His likeness. And anyone who attacks that most precious gift of life, whether it be an unborn child, whether it be an old person who is on a life support system, whether it be an embryo that is in some state of suspended animation, we as human beings, we don't have the right to say when that life should end. It's God is the author and the finisher of every human life. And when we abrogate that right, when we try to say that we as human beings or as a nation or as a government can decide when a human being has been created or when that life is worth protecting, we're treading on very thin ice. So I'm not going to do a video strictly on this pro-life issue today, but you might say the current dispute that's going on in Washington, D.C. over who has the right to govern the United States for the next 4 years. Is it Donald Trump? Is it Joseph Biden? This election is about far more than just who gets to sit in the Oval Office. It's really about the future of democracy in the free world, and about fairness and about the right of governments to dominate the populace by some evil mechanism. And that's exactly what totalitarian regimes have done throughout history. They've tried to usurp the rights of individuals to make decisions over their own lives and over who they want to govern them. And I pray very hard for the future of the free world and especially for the United States, because that's you might say the last bastion of free speech and freedom of religion in many parts of the world. And today's video is because of the sheer magnitude of what's at stake here. I couldn't ignore the outcry for justice that is being raised up by millions and millions of Americans over the way this election was handled, and over the obvious voter fraud that has to be dealt with. It just can't be swept under the rug. A new administration just can't move into power without having been elected fairly. If it's a fair exchange of power, that's one thing, but there's no acceding to dishonesty. We can't let lies go unexposed. So this is a hymn called the Battle Hymn of the Republic for for all those battling for justice, for truth in the world, whether they be Americans or Russians or Irish, no matter what the nationality, we have to fight for what is right if we want justice and peace in our world. My eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He's trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He's loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible Swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. I have seen him in the watchfires of 100 circling camps. They builded him an altar by the evening dews and damps. I can read his righteous sentence by the dim and glaring lamps. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. In the beauty of the lilies, Christ was born across the sea, with a glory in his bosom that transfigures you and me. As he died to make men holy, let us live to make men free, while God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. We'll pray. We're just praying for the future of democracy in the free world. We pray that the rights of citizens of every nation will be respected, that elections will be handled in a just and in a fair way, that illegal votes will not be counted and will not be recounted, and that valid votes will not be discarded so that an election can be rigged in favor of whatever party may seem to think they have control. God, have mercy on those who are trying to manipulate the future of the American system. May God's justice, may his truth, and may his peace reign in the United States and throughout the world. So we'll say the third sorrowful mystery, the crowning with thorns. We pray that all those who want to wear a crown may first imitate the humility of Christ, who allowed himself to be crowned with thorns and suffered an unjust verdict, so that we could learn how to repent of all the injustice that we may be a part of. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The third sorrowful mystery, crowning with thorns. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. Our Lady of Guadalupe, patroness of the Americas, pray for us. Saint Joseph, foster father of Jesus, universal protector of the Church, pray for us. Saint John Neumann and Saint Elizabeth Ann Seton and all you saints of the United States of America, pray for us. Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountains' majesty, above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and crown thy good with brotherhood, from sea to shining sea. Oh, beautiful for pilgrim feet, whose stern impassioned stress, a thoroughfare for freedom be, across the wilderness. America, America, God mend thine every flaw, confirm thy soul in self-control, thy liberty in law. Thank you so much for watching GFC Visions Growing in Friendship with Christ. I've had a great deal of joy bringing these videos to you for the last 10 months, and I'll continue to do so. I'll continue to use whatever means the Lord gives me to proclaim the gospel of life to this very needy world, a world that is very much in need of healing and a light of truth, which only comes from Christ. And he gives us a peace that this world cannot give and that this world cannot take away. So regardless of what political party you might stand for, whether you be an American, whether you be a Frenchman, whether you be a Canadian, whether you be an Irishman, I think we all stand united in a love for freedom and equality for those whose voice has to be respected and has to be heard. St. John Paul II said that how we treat the most vulnerable human beings is a measure of the civilization of our society, that it's not about how we treat the rich and the powerful and those who can do things for us, but it's how we treat the poor, the marginalized, the unborn, the elderly, the handicapped. That's the measure of our love for God. So let's not abandon this amazing challenge that's been handed on to us. Let's pass on this torch of peace and truth, peace founded on justice and the defense of the rights of every human being from conception to natural death. May God bless you and protect you, and may you have a wonderful 2021. Amen.